So yeah, diving a little bit deeper here, just talking about Lottie Interactions. So this is the most technical part, and I'm going to go through this quite quickly, and I'll be talking about this more in depth at launch. So yeah, if you're wanting to learn more about this and you're a little bit overwhelmed by what I'm about to share with regards to getting the interactions to work, definitely come to launch and you know, be happy to share this in my session, or just sit down with you face to face and sort of work on the laptop and just show you how it's done. But I'm not a coder, Petra's not a coder, but we've both been able to get this to work on the launch website using this. Cool, so this is the standard Lottie embed code. So this here is a file that effectively makes all of the animations happen. It's not unique to your animation at all. It's just the generic Lottie animation file. So having this in the HTML block, without it, nothing would animate. This here is your actual Lottie animation. So this bit here, starting with HTTPS, ending in .json, is your animation preview that's hosted on Lottie. And inside this sort of bracketed Lottie player here is what displays it on the page. So that's really easy to just copy that code like I showed you earlier. If you're wanting to get it to do scroll-based interactions, so over here we've got a looping animation, which is, as I showed you, pretty straightforward to get to work with Lottie. Over here on this side, we actually have this line that's animating based on where you are on the page. And if you scroll back up, it reverses that. Again, this one here is a looping one. And this one here is one based on scroll. This one also is based on scroll. So if you want to do get these Lottie animations to move based on the scroll position, it is a matter of adding some additional code. And we will get this code into a help guide fairly soon, so that you can effectively just copy what we've got here and just swap out your file and adjust a few of the settings if you want to. Okay, so in order to get those scroll-based interactions to work, you need a few more things. And bear with me, I know this probably looks crazy complex, but it's not as complex as it might seem. So this file is the one that was there before, you know, so just the standard one that makes it animate. This is an additional file. So you'll see it mentions interactivity a couple of times. This brings in all those fancy scroll-based effects. So without this one on the page, you know, none of the scroll-based animations will work. And one really key thing to note, if you are doing these interactivity animations, these two files should only appear on the page once. So if you're going to have a page with lots of scroll-based animations, you might want to just hide them in an HTML block somewhere near the top. And yeah, effectively, it'll break the page if you have them on there more than once. And then, so this here is exactly the same as what you had before. The only difference is this extra little bit here, ID equals ultra second Lottie. So this could be whatever you call it. It could be funny person, but the key thing is that this code here and this code here needs to match. So it needs to say funny person here and funny person here. It's case sensitive, so there's a capital L here and a capital L here. And so, yeah, in addition to adding this, you also need to add the scroll interaction. So you'll see here there's two actions. So this first action, all this does is it says stop on the first frame until the animation is 40% up from the bottom. So what we were finding is we were putting animations like this one, you know, up here, and it would be quite a quick animation, and the animation would already be finished on page load. So effectively, we wanted to delay the animation until it was at least 40% up the page. So that's measuring from the bottom, 40% of the height of the page, and then it kicks in. So it's stopped on frame one until you get to that point, and then it cycles through the remaining frames. So that's what this first section here does. And so you can adjust this. You could say from 0 to 30% and just change that from 0 to 0.3 and then 0.3 to 1. So this is just 40%, 40%, 100%. And seek just means cycle through the remaining frames to animate those. And then you just want to change this from 0, which is the first frame, to the last frame. And when you upload the Lottie and there's the controls there, you can see how many frames it was by just cycling that through to the last frame, and it'll tell you what that number is. Cool. So obviously that's a lot more complex than the stuff I showed earlier. Does anyone have any questions around the interactivity options? A good way to get started is just to have a little play on a test site, and just that moment when you get it to work for the first time is pretty cool. Pretty cool indeed. Cool, no questions. Okay, I'll move on to just a few things to keep in mind as I wrap up here. Too many looping Lotties can make the animations feel a bit jumpy. Just keep an eye on it as you add more to a page. So as Taz was asking, Lottie files are fast loading vector graphics, great for feature content and small feature text, but the text is still hidden from Google. So use it sparingly if SEO is important to you. Movement should feel smooth and enhance the page, not feel jarring or overwhelming to the visitor. So it's sort of a new frontier for me with designing for movement. And a lot of the animations that I tried initially were cool ideas in my head, but when I actually animated them in reality, they were a distraction on the page, or they drew your eye to the top of the page and away from the direction that your eye was being drawn down the page. So I think there's sort of a relearning of designing for time, or designing for movement and that sort of movement experience. And so I think, that'll gradually improve the more that we play around with these animations. And it can't be a gimmick. It can't be, cheesy, distracting, sort of overwhelming. It needs to add more professionalism and a more luxurious feel to the design, or maybe more fun for certain brands or clients. But in most cases, it's just about strengthening that brand, adding a bit of interest and movement to the page to keep it interesting as you scroll down. Really good for clients where you're struggling to get great images. Injecting a bit of movement, for a client that might be a consultant or dealing with sort of private medical things, you could add some nice on-brand sort of movement if you're a little bit light on photography. And with looping animations, try not to have a jumpy reset to the first frame. So try and make them loop back on themselves so it seems like an infinite animation, or use that bounce feature.